Hello everyone, welcome back. Let's begin new chapter in history, chapter 2, that is Socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. Everyone in the Europe have seen how French Revolution took place and how that French Revolution brought the idea of individuals' right as well as the system of governance. So almost all the countries in the Europe, they inspired from the French Revolution and then they prepared for themselves as a background for establishing and for bringing the change in their society. One of them, which we are going to discuss in this chapter, is the Russian Revolution. How socialism brought a great change in Russia. Let's see the objective of the chapter. The first topic will be the age of social changes, under which liberals, radicals and conservatives' role we will see, and then industrial society and social changes. Second topic will be the Russian Revolution, under which we will see the Russian Empire in 1914, its economy and society. Also a time period of 1905 revolution, that turbulent time. Third topic will be the Russian Revolution carried by the February Revolution in Petrograd. Along with that, we will see the result of February Revolution and Revolution of October 1917. Then second last topic, we will cover the changes after October Revolution, that is creation of Soviet Union, the Civil War, Stalinism and collectivization. At the end, we will end up the chapter with global influence of Russian Revolution and the USSR. Let us begin with the first topic, the age of social changes. As we know, everyone in European country do not want to see the complete transformation of the society. There were certain groups who were not in the favor of bringing those changes. Let us see in brief. So, the first topic is the age of social changes. Under this, the European society was divided into three groups. Number one called as liberals, and number two were radicals, and third were conservatives. Let us see the idea of liberals under the age of socialism or the social changes. So now these liberals, they wanted to bring the drastic change in society. They wanted to change society and also they wanted that all religion must be respected or tolerant. And second point which they believed were, they opposed complete monarchism in Europe . Now the third point is, they favored individual rights, also they wanted to establish democratic setup of government. So the third point is very important and considerable, that these liberals, they wanted to establish a democratic government. But we cannot say these liberals as a complete democratic, because they did not follow adult franchise completely. Why? Because they have given the right to vote for only men, not for women. It means right to votes were given to the men only and it was not considered for women. That's why we cannot say that liberals were with the complete idea of democracy or democratic. Let us see the ideas of radical towards the age of social changes in Europe. So these radicals, they supported women right. They supported women's right. To vote. For that, they organized various suffragette movement. Moments. So in this way we can say they supported the women's right to vote and for that they organized several suffragette movement. What is the meaning of suffragette movement? Suffragette movement means a kind of movement for giving right to the women for vote. Now towards the second point of radicals, they wanted to establish a nation where government must be based upon majority of population. So with this idea, these radicals, they came up and bought the new ideology. The third and the very important idea bought by the radicals were that they were not against in the existence of private property. But they disliked the concentration of these property only in the hands of few people. It means that every people in Europe, they can exist their private property. Let us see the ideas of conservative towards the age of social changes in Europe. So actually these conservatives, they were the against of ideas of liberals and radicals. It means conservatives were against the ideas of liberals and radicals. Also, these conservatives, they want to bring the change in society and that change should be little gradual in manner and they want to remain with the past. Also, we can say these conservatives, they want to bring the change in the society by respecting their past. They wanted gradual change. In society, by respecting past. So these were the ideas of conservatives which bring a great change in socialism in Europe.
Let us see how industrial society brought the social changes. During the Industrial Revolution, new cities, new industrial regions and new railway lines were developed. It brought men, women and children to the factories. But still the problem of unemployment was common. People were forced to accept long working hours and poor wages. With urbanization, housing and sanitation problem were also growing.
By mid-19th century, the idea of socialism spread in Europe and they suggested and campaigned that property should not be stored in individuals' hands. It must be controlled collectively. So this was the idea of socialism, means the property must be looked after or controlled collectively instead of individual. So this was the idea of socialism in Europe. Let us see the coming of socialism in Europe with the ideas of communist society. So among them, three were very popular. Number one, Robert Owen. He wanted to bring cooperative system in industry. Number two, Karl Marx. He wanted to end up the capitalism. And third one, Friedrich Engels. He favored the ideas of Karl Marx and he also wanted to overthrow capitalism.
Let us see the idea of communist society. Robert Owen, who demanded to build a cooperative community called New Harmony in Indiana, USA. Now Karl Marx argued that industrial society was capitalist and the profit of capitalist was produced by workers. The condition of workers could not improve till the profit was accumulated by private capitalist. He believed that to overthrow capitalism, worker has to construct a radically socialist society where all property was socially controlled. That is, all production units should be nationalized and the society will be the communist society. Friedrich Engels, he joined with Karl Marx to suggest that workers have to overthrow capitalism and the rule of private property. Support for the socialism. Socialists formed an international body called Second International to coordinate their efforts and ideas. In England and Germany, workers formed associations and they set up funds to help their members in the time of distress. They demanded to reduce the working hours and right to vote. In Germany, these associations worked with the Social Democratic Party SPD and helped to win parliamentary seats. By 1905, socialists and trade unions formed Labour Party in Britain and Socialist Party in France. Let us conclude the topic covered in this lecture. The three groups of people, liberals, radicals and conservatives, wanted changes in the society, but in different ways. Liberal opposed dynastic ruling and did not believe in giving votes to women, whereas radicals, they wanted to include adult franchise. Conservatives wanted gradual changes while respecting the past. During Industrial Revolution, when men, women and children bought to the factories, people were forced to accept long working hours and poor wages or salaries. On the other hand, urbanization brought the poor sanitation and housing problem. The group of socialists like Marx, Engels, they added their ideas about changing society. Gradually, socialists formed an international body to coordinate their efforts and ideas. Let's do some questionnaires. Number one, suffragette movement means the movement to give women the right to vote, right to equality, right to property, or none of these. Second question is, Dash did not believe in universal adult franchise, that is, the right to every citizen to vote, liberals, democrats, conservatives, or republic. Third question. They felt only men with the property should have vote and women should not have vote. Who are they? Democrats, radicals, liberals, or conservatives? Answer all these questions in the comment section. Thank you for watching.